Hello, my name's Brenda Zechmeister, and I am one of the yoga instructors for Let's Get Physical, an initiative of Price Hill Will in Cincinnati, Ohio. And today we're going to do a yoga strength class. And so this should be fairly accessible for everyone. I will show some modifications along the way. If you wish to use a block, to help with some of the poses, you might want to go ahead and grab a block. And maybe if you don't have a block, maybe just pile up a couple of books or something like that. So we will go ahead and get started. So let's just start out with sitting in what we call easy pose, and that's with your legs crossed. And if that doesn't feel comfortable, you can just bring your feet out a little bit, making kind of a diamond shape and putting the soles of your feet together. And I'm going to see if I can make a little adjustment to the camera here because I don't know if you can see my feet. So perhaps you can, perhaps you can't. I can't tell. So anyway, we'll just start out in easy pose. So just find a comfortable position here. And just close your eyes. Notice your breath. Perhaps slow the breath down a little bit to three or four counts. So just breathing out, one, two, three, and then breathe in, one, two, three, out, two, three. And in, two, three, and out. And just maintain this nice, even breathing as you go throughout your practice today. If you'd like, you can take a moment to set an intention for your practice, just finding a word or a phrase that you can use as a mantra. Something simple like, be strong. Or let go, breathe. Whatever will help to remind you of what it is you need to remember, helping you keep your focus. And so, on your next exhale, let's bring the chin down to the chest and just relax through the back of your neck. You're still sitting up tall. Let the shoulders gently fall away from your ears. We're letting go of any tightness in the back of the neck and across the shoulders. And then from there, bring your fingertips down to the floor on either side of your hips. And on your inhale, roll the head over to one side. And just keep your shoulders relaxed and just feel a stretch on the opposite side of your neck. Breathing into that. And then as you exhale, bring it back to center. And on your next breath, roll the head over to the other side. Again, keeping the shoulders relaxed, feeling a stretch on the opposite side. And then as you exhale, bring it back to center. Interlace your fingers in front of you and stretch your arms out with your palms faced out and then round your back. We're keeping the chin tucked in and just stretch the arms away from your body and take a few deep breaths here. Breathing into that space, you're going to feel the upper back kind of expand. And with each breath, feel that release of any tightness through the upper back and between the shoulder blades. And then on your next inhale, straighten your spine and bring the arms up overhead and turn your hands so that they're now facing the top of your head. We're going to bring the pointer fingers out, and as you breathe in, stretch up a little bit taller, and then exhale, lean to your one side. And you want to keep rooting down through the tailbone, through your sit bones, and stretching up towards the ceiling. Nice deep breaths expanding through the rib cage. And then bring your body back to center and exhale to the other side. Again, rooting down, stretching up, each breath expanding through the ribs. And then inhale, bring it back to center. And exhale, relax your arms down. And let's bring the hands behind the body. I'm just going to sit sideways so that you can see, interlacing your fingers behind your back and straighten your arms and kind of squeeze those shoulder blades together. And then from there, we're just going to draw the arms away from the body. Maybe tilt the head up just a little bit to open up through your throat and across your chest, breathing into that space. And then exhale, release. From here, if you have your legs crossed, go ahead and open them up for a moment, noticing which leg comes out first, and just kind of shake them all about, loosening up any tightness that you might have in the joints. And then once you feel complete with that, you can bring it into stillness, and the leg that went out first is going to come in first. So essentially, we're crossing our legs in the other direction. From here, place your hands on the floor in front of you. Nice tall spine. Take a breath in, and as you exhale, walk your hands out away from you and relax over those crossed legs. Again, if the crossed legs don't feel good, you can have them out, soles of your feet together, or maybe just have them straight out and a little bit in a V. And what we want to do here is just relax all the way down your back. So your head is getting heavy, and as you breathe, perhaps you can go deeper into your pose, walking your hands out maybe a little bit further. You want to relax all the way down into your lower back and hips. And then on an inhale, walk your hands over to the one side, so that your torso comes over that knee. And then as you exhale, let your body relax over that leg. You're gonna feel a nice stretch in the opposite hip area into the glutes. So with each breath, just feel yourself relaxing there, releasing any tightness. Taking one more breath. And as you release that breath, come back to center. And then on your next breath, walk your hands over to the other side. Exhale, relax over that knee. And you may find that this one side, you can go deeper than the other side. And that's normal. That one side's different than the other. So just observing, no judgment. Just relax here, let go of any tightness, taking one more breath in, and as you exhale, bring it back to center. And just notice, again, if you can walk your hands out further, now that you're stretched out on either side, breathing into your intention, and then as you breathe in, walk your hands in towards your body, coming up out of the pose. So from here, we're going to use the block. We're going to place the block on the one side. And so the block just essentially brings the ground up a little bit taller or closer to your body. You don't need to have the block. If your arm is comfortable resting on the floor, that's just fine too. And I'm going to come down onto my forearm, and another modification of it is just to be resting on your wrist. But I like to protect my wrist as much as possible, so coming down onto the forearm. And we want that shoulder stacked right over the elbow. So it's a nice line there. Your elbow is supporting your shoulder. From here, I'm going to keep the leg that's closest to my arm bent in with the foot closest into my groin area. And the other leg is going to be stretched out as long as I can make it. Maybe even like pointing the toes. And then I'm going to open up the shoulders, pull the shoulders back, open up through the chest, I should say. And then turning that free hand upwards, palm face up, inhale and stretch it out over your body. And breathe into this stretch. Feel your body getting longer with each inhale. We're pressing down with our arm into the block. Taking one more breath, and as you exhale, go ahead and release and bend the leg that was straight out and reach for your ankle. And we're going to pull that heel back towards the sit bone. And we want to be gentle here. We never want to force anything. So it's just going as far as you can in the pose. Be gentle with yourself. And so we want to get a nice stretch through the quads there on the top leg. And even maybe bring that chest out a little bit, tilting the head back slightly, breathing into the stretch through the quads. Taking one more breath. And as you exhale, bring that knee back in and push yourself up. And let's bring the block or the book over to the other side. And so the leg that's in closest to the arm. Again, that foot's in close to your groin and the other one's stretched out. And we're resting on that block, shoulder right over the elbow. Pointing your toes, draw your shoulders back, turn that free arm so your palm is facing up towards the ceiling. And as you breathe in, bring it over your head and just stretch it out. And really breathe into this stretch. Feel with each breath that perhaps you're getting longer on each side. Taking one more breath. And exhaling, bend your leg, bend your arm, reach for your ankle, and then pull that heel back by the sit bone. Put a little arch in the back, open up through your chest. One more breath. And then as you exhale, go ahead and release and push yourself up. I'm going to put the block just to the side for the moment. Let's bring the feet in front of you. We're going to lean back on the hands and we're going to windshield wipe the knees side to side. And so you can either do just a gentle stretching, you know, a little bit going side to side, or if you really want to get a nice stretch, bring your knees all the way down towards the floor on each side. And breathe with each movement. Breathing out as you go to one side and breathing in, coming back up. Try to keep the upper part of your body facing forward so that you get a nice stretch into each side through your waist. So once you've completed this same amount, an equal amount on both sides, just bring them back to center. And let's come onto our hands and knees. So this is called tabletop. I'm going to move my block out of the way here. So in tabletop, the hips are right over the knees and the shoulders are directly over your wrists. We want to have a straight back. And we want to press down through the palms of the hands directly beneath the knuckles so that we're engaging the muscles in the arms. We're going to begin strengthening the arms here. So from here, just relax your belly and look up into your cow. And then as you exhale, curl your tailbone under, arch your back, and look towards the navel and the cat as you arch your back. Breathing in. Relax the belly, look up in the cow, and then breathing out, arch your back, draw that navel in towards the spine, look towards the navel and the cat. Just do a few of these going at your own pace. Follow the rhythm of your breath. Maybe recalling your mantra, if that's helpful. And let's do one more. And once you've completed your cat, bring it back to stillness and let's stretch out the left leg. And again, we're pressing down through the palms of the hands. And you're going to be on the ball of that left foot so that your toes are on the floor, your heel is up. And you want to get a nice stretch through the calf muscle. And then from there, bring the right arm straight out. And so you can stay here. If you want to challenge yourself, you can bring that left leg up. Draw that navel in towards the spine. Feel like a little heat here. Again, pressing down through the palm of the hand that's on the floor so that we're strengthening through the arm. At any time, you can bring it down. We'll take one more breath here. And then as you breathe out, go ahead and bring it back to tabletop. We'll do the same thing on the other side. So right leg goes out, ball of the foot on the floor, toes curled under, stretching through your calf. And then bring out the left arm. We're pressing down through the right hand, the palm of the hand. Raise your right leg if you wish, or you can keep it on the floor and stretch it out here. Draw that navel in towards the spine. We're building strength in our core, in our arms, through our back. Again, anytime you can bring it down. We'll take one more breath. And then exhaling, bring it back to tabletop. And let's walk the feet or just scoot the feet over to the left and kind of lean your hip to the right and look over your left shoulder at your feet and breathe into the right side of the body. And then as you exhale, bring it back to center. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Exhale, bring it back to center. Curl your toes under. And as you inhale, raise your hips up. Bring your head back by your upper arms. And let's walk the dog, bending one knee and then the other. And then bring it into stillness. Stretch. Come up on your toes, stretch the backs of your legs, and then bring your heels towards the ground. Keep your arms nice and strong, your upper back. And then exhaling, bend your knees, bring them down to the ground. Bring the tops of the feet to the mat, and bring the sit bones all the way back toward your heels. You want to bring your tummy on top of your thighs. And stretch your arms out, bring your forehead to the floor. And so just relax here in your child's pose. I'm slightly out of it just so that I can talk and not be muffled in the ground here. Just breathe. Feel with each breath that you're releasing and letting go of any tension that you might be holding in the body. This is a great pose to really surrender and release anything that you'd like to let go of. You might scan your body. Notice where you're holding tension. And just breathe. I'm going to just take a few more breaths here. On your next inhale, Let's come back up to tabletop. Curl your toes under, press down through the palms of your hands. Raise your hips up. Come up onto your toes. Exhale, stretch those heels towards the ground. Feel strong through your shoulders, your upper back. And then looking between the hands, you can either walk the feet forward or you can do a little hop. I'm just going to walk my feet forward and relax your head, just coming into like a rag doll position. You want to just let the top of the head relax towards the floor. Let your arms dangle, relaxing, bending at your hips. And maybe shake your head out, yes and no, releasing any tightness through the neck. It feels good. You can roll your shoulders as well. Just let gravity kind of help you out here. And then whenever you feel complete, go ahead and bring it into stillness. We're going to put a little bend into the knees. You want to keep your chin tucked in and gently roll up. Feel like you're rolling up one vertebrae at a time until you're all the way up. And then you can bring the chin to be parallel to the floor. And so in here, we're going to stand in mountain pose. I'm going to stay kind of sideways here so you can see the alignment of the pose. You want to bring the feet within an inch or two of each other and maybe kind of rock back and forth a little bit. And then come into stillness right in the center where you feel like you're standing on all four corners of each foot. The space behind your big toe, your baby toe, in the back two corners of your heels, feeling evenly balanced. And then imagine that you are drawing strength up through the earth. And that strength is coming in through the bottoms of the feet, up into your legs. Feeling your legs getting stronger with each breath. And here comes my kitty. This is Earth the Kitty. And then that strength continues to come up your mountain through the midsection of the body, and you want to be careful that you're not like hyperextending or slouching. You want to be just very neutral. So neutralize hip area, tailbone pulling down. Draw that navel in towards the spine. Feel your spine elongate. Relax your shoulders, your arms. Lengthen through your neck and just continue to draw that strength all the way up your body and out through the top of your head. And so if you're not already, go ahead and come to the top of your mat. And we're going to do a moon salutation. And I believe there's a full moon tomorrow. I could be wrong, but I think there's a full moon tomorrow. So if not, well, we're just doing a moon salutation anyway. So we're going to bring the arms up overhead as you breathe in. And then as you exhale, let your arms go down all the way, fingertips reaching towards the floor. Relax your forehead down. Inhale, come up slightly and straighten your spine, hands on your shins. And then as you exhale, bend your knees, place your hands on the ground. And then inhaling, go ahead and bring both legs out. I'm sorry, we're doing a sun salutation. Wow, I guess my brain didn't align with my body here. So we're going to start with the sun salutation. It's going to be a little modification here. As you exhale, go ahead and bring your knees down to the ground. Turn that right foot out, and as you inhale, Straighten out the left leg and bring that left arm up. And so this is a modification here. I'm going to show you the other one later on. We'll do this again. Exhale, bring the hand back down, bring the foot in. Exhale, bring your heels towards, or your sit bones towards your heels, coming into child's pose. As you breathe in, bring yourself back up to tabletop. And then stretch out your right leg. Bring the other foot out. Inhale the right arm up, right leg stretched out. Exhale, bring everything back into center, into tabletop. Curl the toes under, inhale, up, downward facing dog. Exhale, bring your feet back in. Inhale, come up slightly, flat back. Exhale, relax forward. On an inhale, bring your arms up overhead. Bring the palms together. And then exhale, bring your hands to your heart center. And just breathe. And so we're going to do a few more flows here just to kind of strengthen the body, build up the heat. So we'll do a similar flow to the one we just did with a little bit more strengthening. If you were going to go into a side plank, I showed you the modified side plank with the bent knee and the one leg out. And so the other one will be a full side plank. So you can do either one. So inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, forward bend, lightly touching the earth. Inhale, come up slightly, flatten your back, hands on your shins. Exhale, bend your knees and bring your hands down to the floor. On your next breath, bring both legs straight out. And exhale, bring them down to the ground. On your next inhale, you can either do the modified side plank, or if you wish to do the full, bring your legs back up. And turn to the side, bringing that arm up. Exhale, bring it back down. On your next breath, inhale to the other side. Exhale, bring it back down. On your next breath, bring your body back. Exhale, come into child's pose. Your next inhale, bring it back to tabletop. Curl the toes under. And breathing in again, bring your hips up, downward facing dog. Exhale, walk your feet forward or come and hop them forward. Inhale, lengthen, hands on your shins. Exhale, relax, bending the knees. On your next breath, bring your arms up. Palms together. Exhale, hands to your heart center. So breathing here, relax your shoulders and just notice, check in with your body. Notice how it feels. So a couple more flows. Inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, forward bend, lightly touching the earth. Inhale, come up slightly, hands on your shins. Exhale, bend your legs and place your hands flat on the floor. On your next inhale, bring your left leg straight back. And as you exhale, you can either bring your knee down to the ground or just turn your foot out slightly. Wherever you are, breathing in, let's bring the arms up. Exhale, open up to like a goalpost. Take a breath in here. And exhale, lower the arms, bring them behind your body, interlace your fingers. Breathing in, bring the arms away from your body. Exhale, keep your body straight, lower your body down. And you can either let it rest on your thigh or bring it down lower than inside of your leg, your inside of your thigh. Breathing here. And then on your next breath, bring your body back up. Exhale, a little back bend. Inhale, bring your body back upright. And exhale, release your hands and bring your foot forward. Breathing here. On an inhale, let's bring the arms up. Exhale, forward bend, lightly touching the floor. Inhaling, come up slightly, hands on shins, flat back. Exhale, bend your knees, hands on the ground. On an inhale, bring your right leg straight back. And as you exhale, either bring the knee to the ground or turn the foot out slightly. On your next inhale, we'll bring the arms up. Exhale, open up the arms into the goalpost. Breathe in. And as you exhale, lower the arms, bring them behind your back, interlacing the fingers. Inhale, bring them away from your body. Exhale, hinge forward, either resting on your thigh or on the inside of your thigh. Breathing here. And then as you breathe in again, come back up, lower the arms. Exhale, little back bend. Inhale, come back upright. And then as you exhale, release your hands and bring the foot forward. And again, we're just going to breathe here. Bring your hands to your heart center. And notice, check in with your body. Is your heart rate going up a little bit? Are you breathing a little bit heavier? Are you feeling warmer? Just noticing. So, inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, forward bend, lightly touch the mat. Inhale, come up slightly, hands on shins, flat back. Exhale, bend the knees, place your hands on the ground. On your next inhale, either jump your feet back or go ahead and walk them back so you come into plank. And then as you exhale, bend your knees, bring them down to the ground. Take a breath here. And then exhaling again, come down onto your forearms and clasp your hands. Pressing down through your arms. Exhale, forehead to your arms, relax. On your next inhale, bring your head back up, stretch out your legs, pressing down to the arms. And let's just take a few breaths here. At any time, you can bring your knees to the ground, but try to keep the legs straight if you can. Taking one more breath. And then exhale, if you're not already, bring your knees down to the ground. Exhale, child's pose. On your next breath, bring your hands to the floor, come into tabletop. Exhale, close your, or to curl your toes under. Inhale, hips up, downward facing dog. Breathing here, and then looking between your hands, let's walk the feet forward. Exhale, relax forward, bend your knees. Inhale, bring the arms up overhead, palms together. Exhale, bring them down at your heart center, and check in with your body. Relax your shoulders. Just bringing your body back into that nice alignment. Feel the energy coming from the ground, all up through your body, all the way up to the top of your head. So we will end with a moon salutation. In this one, I'm going to stand facing you so that you can, I think it's a little bit easier to describe. And so we'll start out with the modified moon salutation. So bringing your palms face up on either side, inhale, bring them up overhead. And we're just going to bring the palms together, interlocking the thumbs if you wish. Take another breath in and let's stretch up real tall. Bring your arms back by your ears if you can. And as you exhale, lean to your left. And then inhale, come back to center. And exhale to the other side. Inhale, bring it back to center. And exhale, bring the arms straight out into a T. Bring your feet out wide. Toes facing forward. On your next breath, bring your arms into a goalpost and turn the toes out slightly. And as you breathe out, bend your knees, coming into a goddess pose. And let's take a few breaths here to really build a fire through the thighs. Try to keep a nice straight spine. Try to keep your arms parallel to the earth. Don't want them sagging like that. We want to have a nice kind of draw the shoulder blades back towards each other. If you can go deeper into your goddess pose, you can. And then on your next inhale, go ahead, straighten your legs. Exhale, let's lower the arms down. On your next breath, we're going to bring, this is the modified one, we're going to bring one arm up and the other one down, looking up at the ceiling. And then exhale, let's come back to star. Inhale, the other arm up, the other one down. Exhale, come back to star. Turning your palms upward, inhale, bring them back together. Bring the feet back together. And exhale to the one side. Inhale back to center. And exhale to the other side. Inhale, bring it back to center. And then exhale, bring your hands, palms together. And just notice, check in with your body. Notice how you're feeling. So before we do the next one, I'm gonna demonstrate the sideways star using the block. So if you have a block, you might wanna get that. And so the first time we did it, we went to either side. This time we're going to place the block on the ground to help us. And we're gonna really draw that shoulder back and kind of press down into the block and raise that other leg and the arm up. So if that doesn't feel good to you, feel free to just go to either side like we did before, you know, with our legs wide like that. And again, this is a modification as well. If you are good not using the block and just doing this on your own, feel free to eliminate the block altogether. The other way, and I don't have a wall behind me, another nice way to do the sideways star is to have the wall behind you to support your body in balance and everything. And so that's how I started with this, was to bring my body up against a wall, and that was really helpful. So have your block be handy. We're going to start on this side, so maybe just go ahead and place your block down there so that it's there. So standing in the mountain, Inhale, bring your arms up overhead, palms together. And as you exhale, lean to the side that your block is on. Inhale, bring it back to center. And exhale to the other side. These are half moons. Breathing in, we come back to center. And exhale, bring the arms out. Bring the feet out, toes facing forward. Taking a breath here. On your next breath, bring your arms into the goalpost. Turn your toes out slightly and exhale, come into your goddess pose. And I like to take a few breaths here just to really strengthen through the thighs, going as low as you can. Until you can bring the thighs parallel to the earth. I can't quite do that, so. And then on your next inhale, go ahead and bring it back up. Exhale the arms back out. On your next inhale, bring your hand down toward your block. Situate yourself and then bring your leg up. Coming into your sideways star. And then on your next breath, bring your block with you. Transfer to the other side. Taking a breath here. Exhale, lean to the other side. I'm going to bring that block in closer so you can see the upper body. And we're just bringing up that other leg. And then as you exhale, you can leave the block on the ground. We come back to center. Turning your palms upward. Inhale, bring the palms together. Bring your feet together. And as you exhale, now lean to the other side, the side where your block is. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale to the other side. Inhale, bring it back to center. And as you exhale, just relax your hands down at your sides and just check in with your body. Breathe into your intention. So we're going to do one more flow to bring ourselves down onto the ground. So again, coming to the top of your mat, standing tall into your mountain pose, palms face up. Inhale, bring them up overhead, palms together. Exhale, forward bend and bring your fingertips to the floor. Inhale, come up slightly and straighten your back, hands on your shins. And exhale, bend your knees, place your hands flat on the floor. On your next inhale, bring your legs straight back. And then exhale, bring your knees to the ground. And then on your next inhale, we're going to bring our bodies down to the ground. So your hands are going to be on either side by your armpits. Shoulders drawn back, legs straight out. Let's press down through the hands and bring the body up into upward facing dog. And really push down through your hands here. Draw your shoulders away from your ears and relax your lower back. And so you can keep your knees resting on the ground. I have the tops of the feet on the floor. And you can push up through the tops of your feet. So your thighs, your knees come up off the ground. Exhale, lower them back down. Breathing here. And as you exhale, bend your elbows, keep them tucked in close, and gently lower your body down. On your next breath, let's bend the legs. Reach back for your ankles. If you can't reach your ankles, just reach as far back for your ankles as you can. And so we're just going to kind of hug those heels in, bring your chest up. Breathing. And then exhale, relax, release your feet. And let's make a pillow with the arms, kind of crossing your arms in front of you. And let your forehead go down onto your arms and just relax there. Relax the back of your neck, your shoulders. And so bring your head up off your arms. Let's bring the hands back by the armpits again. Elbows in close to the body. Draw your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale to slowly curl up, straightening your arms. And then bring yourself into tabletop. Bring your knees in. Bring your legs to the side. And let's come into a seated position. So let's start with a twist. Bring one leg over the other one. The other one is straight, the one is bent. And so the one that's straight, we're gonna take that same arm and you're either gonna just place your hand on the outside of your knee there, or you can put that knee in the crook of your arm, whichever one feels better to you. And then you wanna sit up real tall, inhale the other one up, and as you exhale, bring it behind you and look over that shoulder. Each inhale, feel your spine lengthen. Each exhale, look a little bit further behind you. And then on your next breath, bring your gaze forward. And then exhale, release. And let's bring the other leg over. And however you had the hold on the other side, let's do the same here. Inhale that other arm up. Exhale, bring it behind you and look over that shoulder. Breathing in and lengthen, and breathing out, looking a little bit deeper. And then on your next breath, bring your gaze forward. And exhale, we'll go ahead and release. So let's bring the legs straight out. I'm gonna place the hands, palms face down on either side of the hips, and sit up tall. Feel maybe rock side to side, get those sit bones really connected to the floor, and just lengthen through your spine. So this is very similar to mountain pose. We want to feel the elongation of the spine, creating space in between each vertebrae. And then turning your palms upward, let's inhale them up till they're parallel to each other. And as you exhale, just hinge from your hips. Your back is straight. And so we're not going very far here. Just want to get just a little forward bend. Breathing into it. Feel the lengthening through your back. And then let's put a little bend into the knees. Go ahead and round your back. And bring your hands either to your feet or to your ankles or shins or even just to the sides of your legs. Let your forehead come down towards your legs and relax here. We're going to take some nice deep breaths here. Feel each breath kind of opening up through your back, letting go of any tension that might still be there. On your next inhale, walk your hands in towards your body to bring yourself up out of the pose. And let's once again place the hands on either side of the hips on the floor, sitting up tall, and just breathe. Maybe close your eyes and check in with your body and notice how you're feeling. And so let's go ahead and come onto our backs. If you have a block, Go ahead and bring the block with you. And so we're going to start out with our feet on the floor, our knees are bent. And we're just going to, if you have the block, go ahead and raise your hips and slide that block right underneath the hips, kind of centering it right around the sacrum. And then let your hips, just the backs of your hips, just relax there. Bring your arms out at your sides, palms face up, and relax that space in between your hip bones. Just feel like everything is melting there. And so you can still do this without the block. It just feels a little bit different. And then on your next breath, go ahead and bring your legs straight up, making any adjustments that you need to make with your block. And then once you're situated there, we're going to alternate pointing the toes so you feel that stretch on the tops of your feet, down into your shins, maybe a little bit to the sides, and then flexing the feet like you're holding up the ceiling. Feel the stretch into the calves, and then just alternate there. And then let's rotate the feet in circles. And whenever it feels right, you can go in the other direction with the feet. And then when you feel complete there, just relax the feet. And anytime you can hold on to the backs of your legs if they get tired, or even maybe bring them down all together. But we're trying to get all the benefits of a like standing on our head without having to stand on the head. So we're just getting, you know, an opposite flow in the body. Usually everything is upright, so now we bring it upside down. This is great, especially if you have a tendency to have swollen ankles. Helps to relieve that. Let's take a couple more breaths here. And then on an exhale, go ahead and bend your legs. And let's bring the feet down to the floor. We're going to raise the hips up slightly to bring release that block. And then bring the hips back down to the floor. Let's bring the knees into the chest. And just kind of roll a little bit side to side. And then bring them back to center. Let's open up a little bit, bringing the feet up. Let's reach for the big toes with your forefinger and your middle finger. And then open up the feet and the legs. And again, rock side to side. Happy baby. So feel very carefree here, very playful, letting your inner child come out to play. Gently massaging the back, noticing all the sensations in the body. Feeling that sense of freedom. And then go ahead and bring it back into the stillness. We'll bring the feet back together, release your toes, and go ahead, hug your knees in and just relax. Relax your back, your shoulders, your hips. From here, bring your feet down to the floor. Knees are still bent, palms face down, and just do a little side to side with the knees, releasing any tightness from the hips. And then once You've done an equal amount on both sides. We'll bring it back to stillness in the center and stretch out the legs. Let your feet relax out to either side. And so I'm just going to bring you into relaxation. So just stay lying down as I come seated up. Let your feet relax out to either side. Arms resting a few inches away from your body, palms face up. At the top of your head, feel really relaxed. There's a nice warm sensation there. And then that warmth is beginning to cascade down your head, on through the sides of your head and down your forehead, releasing any lines in your forehead, softening through your eyes, and relaxing your cheeks and all around your mouth. Just let your lips part slightly if that feels good. Letting your tongue relax, relax your jaw. And then feel that warmth cascading down your throat, down your neck, loosening any tightness that you might be holding. Cascading down your shoulders, down your back. Just let your whole back fully release onto the floor, letting go of any tightness there. Let go of any tightness across your chest. Feel all the organs in your belly soften. Softening in that space in between the hip bones. Just feel everything melting. Softening through your glutes. And continue to let that relaxation come down into your legs, releasing any tightness through your thighs, softening your knees, and then relaxing into your calves and your shins, down into your ankles, and finally your feet, the tops of the feet, the toes, the heels, and the bottoms of the feet. And so we'll just remain here for a moment in the silence. Gently bring your awareness back to the space, making any subtle movements like wiggling the toes, maybe rotating the feet in circles, and wiggling the fingers, rotating the hands. And then taking your time, bring your knees into your chest and just gently rock side to side. Gradually bringing yourself to rest onto your right side. And so just make yourself comfortable there for another moment. bringing awareness into the body once again. Notice if there's any areas that feel a little bit more open now. The energy is moving more freely through the body. And just breathe into those areas. Remember your mantra. And so again, taking your time, gently push yourself up and come back to your seated position. And we're going to close with one Om. So bringing your forefinger and your thumbs together, let them rest on your knees. Gently let go of the breath that you're on. Take a nice breath in through your nose and let it out through your mouth. And then take another deep breath to Om. Om. And bringing the palms together to your heart center, recall the intention that you started out with and breathe it into every cell in your body, making it a part of who you are. The light in me sees and honors the light in you. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining us here. Again, my name is Brenda Zechmeister. I'm one of the yoga instructors for Let's Get Physical, a health and wellness initiative of Price Hill Will in Cincinnati. If you would like to support these programs to keep them going, feel free to visit their website, pricehillwill.org, and click on the donate button and just make a note that you want your donation to go to Let's Get Physical. Otherwise, we will look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. I will be back in the same place at 6 o'clock this time, doing a gentle yoga class. And so I look forward to seeing you then. So make it a good rest of your day and a good day tomorrow until we meet again. Take care.